Again, with Alexandru Olteanu and Demir Racek. Cristi, you have the floor. Everything looks good.
Thank you, Traian. So, you could see my screen. Everything's okay?
Yes, yes.
Okay, thank you. Good. So, hello. I'm Cristi. I'm a student at Master University Polytechnica of Bucharest. I am also Teodora's classmate. Wait a second. I have a small problem and I will... Okay, my notes. Yeah, and together with Alexandru Olteanu and Emil Racek, we are working on developing a recommender system for Montessori kindergartens. And although the recommender systems have been a highly debated topic and widely used technology over the years, their usage is more present in areas such as social networks like Facebook, Instagram, or even LinkedIn, on streaming platforms. Sorry.
Yeah, I think we're losing you.
Hear me? Okay. I will stop my video.
Yes, will... perfect.
Okay. Sorry. My network connection is poor. I should start again. Where do you lose me?
Yes, I think you can start again. We were just saying about recommender systems being used and...
Yeah, so they are used in different areas, such as social networks, streaming platforms, or shopping platforms. And the purpose of this paper and of all the research and development that will take place later is to extend the functionality of those recommender systems to an educational environment, like Montessori kindergarten. Before going through all the current approaches, we need to briefly introduce the Montessori method. The Montessori educational method existed for almost 100 years, but in the last decades, it becomes more and more popular. It is characterized by providing a prepared environment, tidy, pleasing in appearance, simple, where each element exists for a reason in order to help the development of the child. So this prepared system provides opportunities to commit to interesting and freely chosen work consisting of long periods of uninterrupted concentration. Children could develop basic cognitive abilities, working with concrete materials, scientifically designed. So as can be seen, all this methodology comes with a large number of responsibilities and a remarkable amount of information. Activities at different stages, time tracking, and so on. So, hence, with the passage of time, various platforms such as Montessori Compass or Transparent Classroom have emerged in order to bring advantages to parties involved, like teachers, children, and parents. However, none of the existing platforms offer a recommender system for their users. Therefore, when teachers are required to guide the children to a new activity, they could do this only going through the entire history of previous activities, which is time consuming. So finally, our ultimate goal for this recommender system is to integrate with our platform, Montesmile. What is Montesmile? Montesmile is an online educational management platform, especially for Montessori kindergartens, which address the needs of both kindergarten employees and parents in order to, let's say, bring a better educational experience. One thing that's important to notice is that this project is received from five Montessori kindergartens in Bucharest and on their requirements. Requirements which also include the recommender system. Besides the well-knowners, teachers, and parents, the montage materials and lessons have a special structure that allows them to be represented like a directed acyclic graph. For each area, there are certain root nodes. I can see that you lost me again, right?
Yes, Christy. Okay. The connection was lost again. Now we can hear you better, but the presentation, the share screen is gone.
Okay.
It was on the activity graph on the deck.
I'm sorry. I also plugged my Ethernet cable. I don't know what to do. What else to do? Okay.
About, I think we're okay. Go on.
Okay. So for each area, there are certain nodes, and the other nodes are that are preceded by one or more nodes, which may or may not be the road type. So for a better follow-up of the curriculum, it is recommended that the lessons should be done in the order represented by the graph. Skipping a step can lead deficiencies in the child's education, and those may block him or her in the following exercises. In this image, you can see a sample for such a dog, and it is very important to notice that their size can be much larger than what they see in the image, because the number of lessons in an area can reach even 200. So, as I said before, there's no recommender system for the Montessori environment. So the first step in our process, which corresponds to all the information in this paper, consists in searching through all the existing approaches of developing a recommender system. We are also interested in the ways those approaches map onto a Montessori environment. So recommender system can be divided into several broad categories. First of all, collaborative filtering, which is based on the idea of word of mouth promotion. The opinion of friends may play a major role in decision making, and moving this behavior into the online environment, friends become equivalent users who have similar behavior or preferences. Therefore, collaborative filtering is based on two main types of data, a set of users and a set of elements or items. In our case, users will be represented by the student and items will be represented by the lessons. More exactly, the relationship between those two entities is the one that matters. This relationship is expressed in terms of rating provided by users and used for further recommender to other users. But due to the fact that it's based on ratings, in our case received from children, collaborative filtering does not seem to be the proper solution for our, because is to bring more time to educators and to make their work more efficient, noting children's feedback. The next one, content-based filtering, relies on the fact that users' preference remain constant, remain the same over time. So, for example, if one student is interested in polishing, and yes, polishing is a lesson in the Montessori curriculum, he or she will not change this interest from one day to another. At the same time, there is a very high chance for him to be interested in other lessons in the same area, but with same specificity, let's say. Unlike collaborative filtering, content-based have two different types of data, a set of users and a set of categories. Of course, users will be represented by the students, but the categories will be represented by areas, which corresponds to lessons. Categories are also known as keywords, and the mechanism compares all the items that are available to be recommended with those that have been already consumed. In this way, we will know whether they are similar or not. Almost all the time, similarity depends on keyword, extracted from the item, description, or on categories in the case that those categories have been annotated. And one more interesting approach we found was this approach for recommender system used in adaptive learning based on the Markov chain. What's an adaptive system? It's a system which aims to provide instruction tailored to the current status of the learner, differing from the traditional classroom experience. So a key component of this learning system is a recommender system, which recommends the next material, video, lectures, practices, and so on, to the learner based on individual characteristics. Therefore, it can be seen that there are a lot of similarities between adaptive learning and Montessori methodology. The main problem which this approach raises up takes into account the fact that the traditional memory-based or model-based course recommender system do not consider the sequence of courses taken by the student. And in the context of course enrollment or for an activity freely chosen, the order in which courses are taken plays an important part in advising and developing a student's academic plan. In the same time, taking into account the order in which students prefer to do the activities, can lead to new approaches in the Montessori methodology. So I want to remind you that this was only the first step in a long process in which a team of people from various backgrounds, software engineers, Montessori educators, parents, works on. Our ultimate goal for this recommender system integrated in the Montesmile platform is to offer a superior educational experience and to help the involved parties. We have already established the data set represented by the lessons history or the progress by the children from four groups from two different kindergartens here in Bucharest, Montessori kindergartens, of course. We are also considering a variant of the recommender system based on feedback received from parents in case that lesson will continue remote in the future due to the COVID pandemic. Our plan is to, for the first version, is to be available on the middle of September. And as I mentioned before, the entire team is working for the best solution. And the fact that unites them is their passion for teaching. So I know that in this conference, there are a lot of people passionate about teaching, like you, Traian. And I appeal to those who have an advice for us to follow or any other question. So that's all from me. And apologize from my poor internet connection.
Okay, thank you, Christine. Don't worry about the internet connections. Very good work on recommending Montessori activities and educational activities even for very young people. Any questions from the participants or suggestions?
Yes, maybe I have a question. It's quite difficult for me to understand how a recommender system could be used at this for this age. I mean, of course, this should be for teachers, not for a learner.
Yeah,
but
obviously.
Which is the reaction of teacher? I mean, what they actually ask, and if you got any evidence of being helpful, because usually
the
teacher of this age tend to be very practical and to react as a as a function of what the children are doing in a given moment. So it's something a little bit strange to me, but maybe you can explain a little bit better.
Sure. As I say, all this research and all the development we made is already based on the, their feedback and on their requirements. They are tired of spending 1 hour every day looking through the children history and to see that, yes, yeah, he played with this toy, he did this, he did this, he did this, and now let's say, see, yes, he should do this polishing. This is very time consuming. And as they said, their requirements, they do not want to do this anymore. I know that there are there is also a small category of teachers who are who don't want to try this. Most of them are, let's so say, a little bit older.
Basically, they wish to have an agenda in which they record the progress of a student. That's actually
yeah, what yeah. But also to they want an agenda who could suggest them to what's the next lesson, maybe.
Okay, thanks.
You're welcome.
Okay, so, thank you, Carlo, for the question. It was exactly the first question I would have liked to ask. So thank you, Christy, for your talk. You. And we're moving to